Hello viewers, I am Rakib. In this lesson, I will discuss about the blur, sharpen and smudge tool in Photoshop. With the blur tool, you can blur part of an image like this. The more strength you set, the more intensively it will be applied. And you have the other options, the blending mode, and if you are working with multiple layers, you have that option, sample all layers, and the hardness and different brush options. That's the sharpen tool. It does the opposite of the blur tool. It sharpens the area of an image. You can see the result. And one thing you should remember, which is the blur tool removes the noise and the sharpen tool increases the noise. Applying any of them too much will not look good. You can see that here. So you will only apply the amount that will look good. And you can do a lot of things using this smudge tool. Like if you choose this brush tip and increase it, and we can hold shift and drag like this, so that will create a pattern for us. So in this way, you can create any pattern using this smudge tool. There are a lot of other ways that you can use this tool. Let's see another example on a different image. In this image, I have completed clipping path around this children. And let's press Ctrl Enter to make the selection. And press Ctrl J to duplicate this selection, and we'll pick a different background. Enter, and now we will set it behind. And if we zoom in, you can see the hair of this child is not looking that good because it's cut out, not a hair masking. We will see how we can apply hair masking later, but now we will see after cut out how we can enhance the hair edges using this smudge tool. So we will keep this layer as a backup, and we will press Ctrl J and uncheck this, and we will select a brush for it and selecting this one, and you can drag like this. That will enhance the edge. So now if you uncheck this and see this one, you can see the difference. Here's the before and here's the after enhanced. So in this way you can apply the smudge tool, and also there's a lot of options for you to select from here. Different brush tips will provide you different results. You can check them out. So that's it for this lesson. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video, then don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. Hope to see you in the next lesson.